We're here at the Splash Shop presented by Enterprise.
This isn't going to be easy, guys.
He has to get all of the surfboards knocked down and then hit the NHL shield.
What better motivation than Matthew Tkachuk in that dunk tank?
He got him!
Wow.
Make some noise for your NHL All-Stars!
In beautiful and bright South Florida, it's the sunshine that normally captures everyone's attention. Along with the epic landscapes and warm, salty air. But this week, there's something else that's a sight to see. The 2023 NHL All-Star Weekend. For the players, the exceptional weather is just an added bonus. It's being named an All-Star that really matters. Whether it's the first time or one of many. It's a platform that allows players to dazzle fans with clever displays of their talent and an opportunity to build camaraderie and memories with peers and family.
I'm excited. I don't think I can say that I've shared the ice with this much talent, you know, ever. I mean, there's the best players in the NHL for a reason.
It's a cool opportunity and a cool weekend to kind of share with the fans, and seeing that it's in sunny Florida, I'm sure a lot of people who have been to All-Star games are going to say this is probably the best one.
You can definitely feel the buzz kind of in the city and the excitement, and it's always fun just kind of interacting with the guys and trying to put on a good show for the fans. I mean, ultimately, that's what we're there to do, so, you know, no better place to do that than the beach.
For some players, the beach is always their backyard. Alongside Florida Panthers captain Alexander Barkov, Matthew Tkachuk is also representing the host team in a city he now proudly calls home.
It's great to be a part of this, you know, this All-Star, all the festivities, and I'm glad that some of the other guys around the league can see, like, you know, the weather and the beach and everything. It just makes it pretty special. So I'm very lucky to be able to play here.
As Tkachuk soaks up the sun and media attention, his second All-Star appearance carries extra special meaning. He'll experience the weekend festivities side by side with his brother Brady.
I'm his biggest supporter. He's mine. And just being able to be in this setting with each other where it's, you know, kind of the best players throughout the league, and being two of those guys, I know my family's very proud.
At this year's Media Day, the Tkachuks join their fellow All-Stars on the podium to face some less than hard-hitting questions.
Andy Vice Freeboom starring you and one of the guys here. Who is it?
Johnny Gaudreau.
Have you been on any jet skis since you've been here?
Might rip out there tomorrow morning and try to get Kev out there with me.
So he's from a different planet, you know?
I grew up being the little brother, and he was always bigger than me.
I always was able to overpower him.
I think it got to the age of 16, 17, where I started getting the same height and a little taller, so things turned from there.
I mean, look at him, he's a mammoth of a human, so I'm not bullying him now.
Today, childhood rivalry is a distant memory for the Tkachuks. Representing two Atlantic Division teams means a rare opportunity to play together.
It's our first time that we've ever played with each other in like a competitive environment.
I won't be happy if he doesn't give me the puck, and probably vice versa. But very, you know, lucky and thankful for the people that got us here, and for us to share it together. It's gonna be really special for our whole family.
Here with Brady Tkachuk. Okay, so all three Tkachuks are out for dinner. Who's paying?
Definitely not him.
Let's settle down. This is my interview.
No, I gotta go with the big man. He usually takes care of us.
All right, the Tkachuk brothers have entered the chat. What are you guys up to?
Another weekend together, I guess.
How many days, Brady, can you guys spend with each other all day, every day before you're like, all right, get out of here. I'm sick of you. We're done.
I feel like we had a little battle last night when I was leaving, so.
It's special for us. We're always together, and that's usually how it always is in the summer, and whenever we're together, it's tough to separate.
as his brother, what is it like to kind of see the season that he's having and just lighting it up?
You know, if I could become the player that he is, I'd be very happy with that. I think Florida's very lucky to have him.
Yeah, I think Matthew's going to want to put on a show in front of his home fans, so I just got to make sure I'm ready to go to follow his lead.
All-Star Weekend is known for amazing displays of skill and creativity. Just like last year on the Las Vegas Strip, in the days before moving indoors, there are two outdoor events, each one unique to South Florida. The first is the Pitch and Puck Contest, featuring four All-Stars, among them Jason Robertson of the Dallas Stars.
Going to the All-Star game for the first time, it's a big moment for me.
I love the journey he's been on. He was never a high draft pick in junior or the NHL. Had to earn everything he got, and now is walking among the elite.
86 degrees outside. Doesn't feel like an NHL experience.
Of course, with the All-Star Game in beautiful South Florida, we gotta have a Florida-themed competition.
It is hockey and golf at the same time.
All I know is that we have our gloves and hockey sticks, and we're not using clubs. It's kind of cool, though, seeing other guys' sticks. Kaprizov, same curve. Wonder if it's game use against us. Probably.
Joining Robertson on the course is Nick Suzuki.
Oh, so there. See you again.
Johnny Gaudreau.
Hey. Good.
And Clayton Keller.
It's one hole. It's a par four. You're hitting with a puck and a hockey stick. When you finally get it on the green, we're replacing the puck with a golf ball.
I feel confident. I feel excited. I feel like I could hopefully get a par, maybe. How'd you start it? Scoop it up, okay. Honestly, if it was actual golfing, I would be nervous. I don't golf ever. Out of my league here. Well, I want to get it going. Oh! Cut that out. What I did? Don't show anyone that.
Going first. All right, I'll spin a tee.
Nick Suzuki, the Montreal captain. And this is a 140-yard hole.
Oh, wow. That's pretty good. You think he can hit the green from there?
Johnny Gaudreau, Johnny Hockey.
Nice shot.
Clayton Keller, maybe the best golfer of the four.
That's pretty good. Might just get a quick dynamic warm-up in here.
Here's Jason Robertson. Oh, we got a worm burner.
You don't want to get it too high.
The worst pool version could
be. Shot from here to the green is going to be tricky.
Can he clear the wall?
Go in, win.
Oh, he did it.
I hammered that one. That almost didn't make it.
Okay, so Clayton Keller now with the approach.
Bringing it in lower. It
gives him some rhythm, and oh, that's a fortuitous bounce.
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
I'll take it.
Here's Johnny.
That's it. It's pretty good.
Nick Suzuki.
That's a good shot.
Get it in low as well.
He gets a front skip.
Wow.
Look at that look on his face, Michael. He wants this.
That closest, too? I got to go again. I gotta shoot mine first again. Not confident. I know it's going right, and you said to hit it a little harder. Should I choke up?
Here's Jason Robertson.
Oh, it gotta be harder than that.
Johnny Hockey.
Oh.
Stay there. Ooh.
So Clayton Keller now.
Good putt.
Oh!
So it all comes down to this. Nick Suzuki has a chance to be the champion.
Brady would be nice. Wow!
And look at the pride on this young man's face. He has won the Chipotle Pitch and Puck Contest.
Good, I don't have to shoot again. Nick had a birdie, so I mean, I can't keep up with that.
Jason was kind of disappointed, but yeah, I guess I got bragging rights right now and to be the first time champ. That's a ton of fun.
At least they didn't let us finish it out, you know, so we know who the winner was. We didn't keep score on the other three, so we'll never know.
Oh,
While the All-Star foursome was putting on a show at the golf course, at the beach, fans are gathering for an up-close look at Florida's newest star.
We're here to see Tkachuk.
Which Tkachuk?
Matthew Tkachuk.
It's only been 7 months since Matthew Tkachuk was traded to Florida from Calgary, but you wouldn't know it by the size of the turnout.
It's completely surpassed what I thought it was gonna be. It's been incredible.
What's up, how are you?
People don't realize how big hockey is down here. So am I signing these, Addy, and giving them, or?
We get those,
or they have stuff? Okay.
Like, as a hockey player, going from team to team, from city to city, could sometimes be an adjustment.
What's up, you like that call?
But really gotten to know a lot of people like outside of the rink that have made it really easy.
So we go to the game on Monday. Can we get like a picture with you on the ice?
Sure, we'll take a picture.
I'm gonna have a selfie sign.
It's just such a relaxed environment. I think that's translated to, you know, me loving it even more, like playing.
Tkachuk across the line with some speed for the forehand. Scores! Tkachuk!
Of course, the good vibes run both ways. With Matthew leading the team in scoring, it's no surprise he's already a fan favorite.
I think you're a really good player.
Thank you very much. It's very nice. Enjoy the sun, guys. This starts at 2.
Yeah, I gotta but they want you 145.
145 there, okay.
I want you there 145.
Okay, I'll call Brady right now.
I don't know where exactly we're going for this.
South Florida might belong to Matthew, but this weekend he's sharing at least part of the spotlight with younger brother and fellow All-Star Brady.
This is your second All-Star, right?
Third, Matthew, third. Second. I want to make sure that's known.
It isn't often brothers are All-Stars, so it's understandable the entire family is well represented.
These are my grandparents, Chuck Tkachuk, and now this is Geraldine Tkachuk.
Even a few down from Boston to back the Tkachuks in the second outdoor event of the Skills Challenge, the Splash Shot.
You know what? They worked hard for this, and they deserve it. They're great on the ice and off the ice. That's what's so important.
Hey, Nene, keep the answer short here. Come on now.
3, 2. What's up, NHL fans? Weeksy, I'm here with PK Subban. We're here at the site of the Splash Shot presented by Enterprise. Fans are going nuts. It's going to be great.
Look at the turnout here. We got a ton of fans. This is exciting. I think as a player, I would love to participate in this.
By far the coolest event I've seen, like, at All-Star.
This isn't going to be easy, guys. 3, 2, 1, go!
4 teams of 2 All-Stars each, with Adam Fox of the Rangers the first to try to get his opponent wet in the shortest amount of time.
You're shooting at surfboards.
He has to get all the surfboards knocked down and then hit the NHL shield.
Once you were done hitting the surfboards, you had to hit the dunk tank.
What better motivation than Matthew Tkachuk in that dunk tank?
Absolutely.
5 feet of water, freezing cold.
I got dunked. I was the first one to have that happen.
All right, guys, let's make some noise for Brady Tkachuk. Come on!
With Matthew seemingly enjoying the cool water, it is now up to brother Brady to quickly dunk Fox's Rangers teammate, Igor Shesterkin.
So Brady Tkachuk now, 26.5 seconds. The clock's going to start there and wind its way down. Oh.
But alas, there will be no storybook victory today.
I don't know if he's going to have enough time.
As Team Tkachuk bows out after the first round.
Oh. One more! Oh, just out of time.
That one's going to hurt for a little bit. I'm just going to be giving it to you all weekend about it.
100 or so shots.
We got Sidney Crosby, the best player in our generation.
And 4 dunks later, the winners are 2 Colorado All-Stars, Mikko Rantanen and Cale Makar.
I was ripping those, man.
Oh, can you get one more?
Make some noise for Cale Makar!
Last year, the Stanley Cup. This year, the first NHL Splash Shot champions.
Like, there's no debate. This is definitely the one that I was looking forward to. I mean, this one just topped it all.
Nice to see you again. That's my son in that.
The big one?
In recent years, Trick shots have become a big part of All-Star Weekend. So at this year's family skate around the day before the skills competition, a special guest is brought in to entertain the kids, as well as players past and present.
Hey, how are you, man? What's your name?
Cole.
Cole, nice to meet you. I'm Zach. You can't beat hockey on a beach. There's so many kids around. The energy is just, it's just captivating. It's honestly incredible. Nice to meet you.
That's my son. You light him up as much as you want.
It's just so inspiring to me just to see the next generation of hockey really gravitate towards growing the game.
My son is super excited out here, and gotta enjoy watching them do their tricks. So gotta pray that it hits you, I think.
You know, when we have events like this at All-Star, it just shows the game in a different light and it attracts so many new eyes to the sport. So it's just an incredible event. Oh, nice save! Looking hot.
For veteran Seth Jones of the Chicago Blackhawks, walking the red carpet on All-Star Weekend is nothing new, but that doesn't mean he's experienced anything quite like this before.
I've been able to be in LA and San Jose, so some good weather spots and some All-Star games, but first time on the beach doing this, and the atmosphere is great. You see everyone's excited. Morale seems a little bit more upbeat when you're on a beach usually.
Throwback.
Yeah. How you doing, bud?
I'm good, how are you?
Hey, I hope you win the hardest shot.
Yeah, I'm gonna try.
With this red carpet on the beach under the hot Florida sun, players need a fashion game plan.
I think it's too hot here for a suit, so maybe you have to go into the closet and figure out, you know, a fashionable statement.
For some, that means comfort and practicality. For others, despite the heat, looking cool is still the way to go.
It's hot out here, no? Leaking out here.
Either way, it's a memorable experience for both fans and players alike. With the skills challenge up next, the trip from the beach to the arena gives the All-Stars an opportunity to cool off and collect their thoughts before showing off their skills.
Were you isolated? Was this everyone? For me?
No, I have a mic on set for right now.
No, that's the app?
Yeah, sorry.
Big mic.
As is usually the case, Skills Night is less about competition and more about bonding with fellow All-Stars from around the league.
Being here in a more relaxed environment, you think you get to show off your personality more and just be yourself where regular season, it's the stress about winning every day.
Thank you.
Great. Have fun, boys. That's yours. All right. The skills event is always, you know, super laid back.
What is your favorite jersey in this room other than yours?
Favorite jersey in here? Good question. I don't think Dallas one's nice. Dallas one's nice, but I gotta go with the Chicago.
Chicago's the best. There it is. He says it's the best.
There you go.
I agree. It's the best one here too.
There's a lot of friendships that you build in hockey that, you know, continue on for your whole life.
I do like Boston.
Boston is great.
I love Boston. Such a great city.
Oh yeah.
We're starting a trend here with the two Macs. We got McJesus and we got Lil Mac. Subinator signing out.
It's always a fun night interacting with the guys and trying to put on a good show for the fans. I mean, ultimately, that's what we're there to do.
Just check the forecast in South Florida. It's All-Star Weekend.
It's a stargazing night.
27th edition of the NHL All-Star Skills Competition.
All right, boys, let's have a good first, okay?
In a sport often called the fastest on Earth.
Introducing your NHL All-Stars competing to be the Upper Deck NHL Fastest Skater.
The first event of Skills Night will crown the fastest skater in the game.
So one of the best skaters on planet Earth. Cale Makar will begin the 2023 All-Star Skills.
Can he be the fastest skater as well?
Oh!
Oh!
See if Kevin Fiala can hop in here and set the tone.
He's like, don't blow an edge, don't blow an edge.
Good finish.
Wow.
Oh, I'd come dead last. I'd be so tired.
Andrei Svechnikov.
Stevenson. Oh, he's a good skater, man.
That's my horse. I picked him for a win.
Chandler Stephenson, and that won't do it.
Ah.
Well, here comes Larkin. He's got his eyes on Andrei Shtrechnikov. Can he beat Shtrechnikov? No.
Whoa, what a surprise.
What a final. We have the Hurricane and the King.
Oh, he's coming. He's coming. He's taking crossovers behind the net.
Oh, he's got it. There's your winner, yeah. Andrei Shtrechnikov.
Good skate, Svetch.
Well, can I take a picture with you guys?
What is that? Oh, is that a mascot?
Can I pet him?
You can't pet him because he's in the stands. We're on the ice.
Up next is the Tendy Tandem. It's a new event designed to feature all 8 All-Star goaltenders, as well as skaters and guests, with a complex set of rules that some players appear to learn quicker than others.
Sid, do you know the rules, how we're going to shoot it?
Because I still can't wrap my head around that.
I guess it's like wherever it ends up. If they get it in, I guess there's 3 points, 2 points, 1 point.
Are we shooting on our own guys then?
I was trying to figure it out. Somebody's explaining the rules. I'm like, that's a lot of parts.
Just make sure you guys know, like, okay, three guys, who's going.
So Stuart Skinner, the Edmonton Oilers goaltender.
Looks good.
Oh,
looks
good. Center cut. Big job! 3-on-0. Come on, Hillary. Finish! Hellebuck with the save.
It takes a while, but once everyone figures it out, one of the night's most memorable moves doesn't come from an NHL All-Star.
Nurse versus Shesterkin. Oh, the Forsberg!
Oh, that was good.
Sarah Nurse is so good.
When the dust settled, it would be the Central to come out on top. UC Saros and Connor Hellebuck winning the inaugural event.
I got Connor Hellebuck and UC Saros. How'd it feel, fella?
You know, it feels great. We came into this one, we really wanted it. I'm not gonna lie.
I put on new skates. It's my second time. My feet are absolutely on fire. Oh my, oh, it's horrible. But other than that, good. Just chilling.
So there's the 5 in the hardest shot competition, and defensemen have dominated this competition.
You're on. I'm gonna talk to you. I'll be on the mic, hot mic.
Are you hot mic to me?
Yeah. Are you shooting too?
Each shooter gets 2 attempts. Here we go. Elias Pettersson goes first.
1-on-2 is respectable for sure.
Pettersson's one of those guys that has a sneaky shot.
Here's Pettersson second.
103.
Whoa.
103.2.
Whoa.
Wow.
Last year's winner was Victor Hedman. Same velocity.
I'm surprised by that. I wouldn't have guessed that he would be over 100.
Rasmus Dahlin trying to bring the lumber, trying to break that 100 mark.
They post 102.3.
Oh, this is a good one.
Seth Jones,
Seth
of the Blackhawks.
Jones, 93. That's. Let's just hope that's a tough reading.
So we have a Swede in the lead. That's great.
It looks harder.
His first shot, 95.7.
Yeah, 105.
I don't know. I don't think I'm that strong.
Here comes the big dog.
Here we go.
It all comes down to this. He won back in 2018 with a shot of 101.3. That won't do it tonight.
Make him scream, Obi. Just wait for my whistle. Get the crowd in here.
Here we go.
Snap.
Oh,
the post.
Double post.
That's a tough one.
Oh, miss.
Elias Pettersson nervously looks on. His 103.2 is going to be tough to beat. There he is. Hoping he's the champ. Oh, just 95.1.
So Elias Pettersson is a winner.
Just the 4th forward ever to win the hardest shot competition.
Hey, sorry for scoring a goal, huh? Post it in?
No.
Sorry for scoring a goal.
No goal.
Oh. What happened to the lights? Something's about to happen. What is he doing? He's wearing sunglasses inside, silly goose.
While the results of the hardest shot might have been a surprise, the next event, the breakaway challenge, would once again deliver as the highlight of the night with its typical combination of skill and creativity.
Being here in a more relaxed environment, I think you get to show off your personality more and just be yourself. When I keep falling down, I go
and pick myself up. I went too long.
You got close, and then I was like, oh my God, I thought he's gonna score. That's the only one I'm supposed to stop. It's in my blood, I can't control it.
Happy wants to hear the crowd.
Yeah, show a little personality, as David Pastrnak says.
This putt is for the Tour Championship. Oh, you can't stop this. We got a lifeguard? I'm
unstoppable. Oh, I can't see anything, buddy.
The old catch it with your hat.
Oh! You got it, buddy. We pulled it off. Buddy, you roofed that.
I still have fun. I still enjoy when the fans love the game. I like it.
Let's go.
Oh, he's a lefty. Oh, my God, he's a lefty.
It's Ovechkin, Crosby, and it's Ovechkin. Scores!
Come on, yeah. Give me a look at that.
Your son's awesome.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Thanks.
How old?
Four.
Knuckles. Whoa, tripping. 2 minutes. I'm out.
I can skate when I was four. So, yeah, he's better than me.
After the Crosby and Ovi show, the night's vibe switched from personality to precision with the always intriguing accuracy shooting contest.
I'm nervous.
I'm so nervous.
That nervous.
Might be a little nervous in accuracy shooting, but I don't think that's a bad thing. It's only hopefully like under 20 seconds.
Well, here will be the people's choice in this event.
Yeah, here we go.
It's gonna help a lot to feel like home, and it is my home.
He can hear the hometown crowd.
25.297.
Like everything, the nerves can kind of get to you.
You miss one, you're screwed.
Brock Nelson. Oh, yeah, he can finish. Islander fans, your boy can snipe.
4 for 5? I'll take that.
Yeah, you
will. I'll take that.
Even the best could be humbled a little bit by this competition.
What do you got here? Accuracy?
No, I don't got anything. I got no skills.
Oh, the poor guy. There we go.
We're at Leon.
I wish I was next.
You go 4 for 4?
4 for 5.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Man, it's so nerve-wracking.
OFD, originally from Dorchester. Kevin Hayes experiencing NHL All-Star weekend. He mentioned how his late brother Jimmy wanted to see him at an All-Star game sometime.
I think I might have the most family members at this event this year.
I did it.
I'm gonna have my brother's kid with me, Bo, so he'll be able to experience with me.
Is this little guy? Now, you told me I could take his tummy, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, let me get that tummy. Can I take that tummy?
Oh, look what it is, it's pretty cute.
I think Bo will probably steal the show at some point.
He's on the other side, we can't go see him yet.
So Connor McDavid will go last, switching events this year.
I'm excited to maybe show some fans that I'm not just a fast skater. You know, there's a little bit more to my game than just speed and just skating around the rink, so I'm excited about that.
It will be interesting to see if he can make his mark on another one of the competitions. Off to a good start. Look out, Brock Nelson.
Yeah. Thanks for coming. Take care. Woo!
And that's the highlight of the night so far. This guy's pretty good.
Like Jesus.
I can be by that guy. That's why.
So a little different here for the semifinal. We're gonna shoot simultaneously.
Side by side, head to head. I gotta go pass now.
Dahlin will pass to Panarin. It's Erik Karlsson to Brock Nelson.
Oh no.
So Nelson beats Panarin, gets his fourth before Arteri does.
It got hairy there for a second. I thought. Missed three straight. Like, I wait, I think I go right again.
Either McDavid or Kadri will be heading to the final.
It'd be a huge upset if Kadri could win this.
Did Kadri beat him?
I think Kadri beat him.
Unbelievable.
Good job, buddy. Guy doesn't miss. 8 for 8. 8 for 8. 8 for 8.
Brock Nelson versus Nazem Kadri.
Nelson off, 2 for 2. And Nelson's your winner.
That was good. That was good. You're a hell of a try, man.
Hey, congrats. Hey, team dinner. Hey. I'm coming. Yeah. Hey, the Metro dominated.
Metro did some good work, man. Hey? Now we got to go for the million, right? Now we got to go.
Have a good time tonight.
Yeah, that's you.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Hey, okay.
As Saturday dawns, the All-Stars switch to game mode, but still find time for the fans.
Have a great day, man. Thank you.
Windy today.
This is the first time Adam Fox is an All-Star, and he's making the most of the honor.
How's the weekend so far?
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Obviously around some great players, and have my family come to the event yesterday. They're coming today, so it's been a pretty cool time for sure. I got to enjoy a little break before this. Came down here a little earlier, so got some sun and got some relaxing, and you know, get voted in by the fans. It's an honor for me, and I'm looking forward to the game today as well. Hey.
Oh, this guy.
We came to party, we came to party. We ain't come in here to hurt nobody. It's go time. Yeah, it's your time. Yeah, break it down, break it.
While first-timer Fox rides the bus,
we just came to party and have a good time.
Another All-Star gets the star treatment with his own car and brings along one of the league's most recognizable and usually well-dressed players.
Sid, you didn't get the casual memo today, or?
I went the opposite. They told us not to wear a suit at the red carpet, so that was like for the game, I'll wear a suit. Might be the only one wheeling in there. It's okay. 35 and older club, they'll understand.
I'm assuming you saw what Mitch was wearing yesterday at the red carpet.
Yeah.
Mitch, maybe, do you think Sid could
rock that? No.
I'd like to see him try to rock it, though. I'd like to see that. That'd be juicy.
I'm very excited to be in the All-Star again. My family is going to be here. It's going to be a great time. It's still competition, you know. If we have a chance to win, why not?
I definitely like winning the All-Star game. It's something that the players have a lot of fun with. You know, there's a little bit of a cash prize at the end, which is always nice, and it's always fun. I'm really looking forward to it.
I'm looking forward to playing a lot of the players that are in the Central Division too, see their talent on the ice and their skills, and trying to win the game.
For the 7th consecutive year, the All-Star Game is actually a 3-on-3 tournament among the NHL's 4 divisions.
Well, you got 3-on-3, very similar to overtime during the regular season.
It's single elimination, so if you lose, you're done.
The difference is, I think you'll see all 3 forwards out there a lot more than the typical 2 forwards and 1 defenseman setup.
You know, from a fan perspective, it's great. It's 3-on-3 hockey, and it's up and down the ice, and you get to see the skills of the best players on the planet.
Today's first semifinal, it's the Pacific against the Central. Then the defending champs, the Metropolitan, will battle the Atlantic. The winners will meet in the championship game, where the victorious team will split $1 million.
With all the glitz and glamour of All-Star Weekend now in the rearview mirror, it's time to get down to the business at hand. Hockey.
Win some money today, hey?
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Let's light them up.
Lace up the boots.
For recently traded All-Star Bo Horvat, this year's game is bittersweet. It's the last time this season he will play with his friend and former teammate, Elias Pettersson.
One last time. Let's at least try to connect for one goal.
We've gone from the fresh water back to the frozen water. The suntan All-Star game about to get underway.
Centering pass.
Oh, big save. Only wants to win this.
Hellebuck looks sharp in the early going.
Dialed in right now.
While Connor Hellebuck stands tall for the Central Division, his offense does what it does best.
Yes.
McKinnon on a break, scores! Nathan McKinnon breaks the ice!
For first-time All-Star Jason Robertson, sharing the ice with so many stars is understandably a bit eye-opening.
How did we match up against these guys? Why are we matched up against them? I've taken one draw in 2 years. It was against you.
Snapped it on me, probably.
No, you. One of the best guys in the league, and I get smoked. Here's my redemption.
Carlson back for the goal. Beautiful passing. And the Pacific is on the board.
Can't turn it over to that line, Robo. You know who those guys are?
I gotta know I'm out again. You guys are wheeling up the ice. They're skating fast, hard. Tight D.
These things typically kind of start out slowly and then a little competitiveness starts to take over.
And that's exactly how this game would go, with an impressive scoring display from both sides.
Seth Jones scores for the Central.
Big goal, Jonesy, big goal.
And a promise made good by Bo Horvat.
Here's Horvat, down low and another goal.
We did it.
Pedersen from his former Canuck teammate Horvat.
All right, Petey.
Let's go. Let's see that goal scoring.
Ultimately allowing the Central Division to come out on top.
And the Central Division will post a 6-4 win in the first of the semifinals.
It was fun to play with them one last time for now. We'll see what happens in the future. But, I mean, it was kind of bittersweet out there. It was a lot of fun.
And we talked about it. Whatever happened, just make sure we score one together. We did.
With the home team up next, anticipation was in the air to see how the Tkachuk tandem would perform.
Home crowd's here to watch you two.
Here in Florida, you got the home team on the Atlantic side, so that should motivate them quite a bit.
And while they may not have been the crowd favorite, the Metropolitan Division was equally motivated.
We know there's a little cash on the line, but there's also a car, too, you know.
Get it going, hey, early. Hey, lay some body up there. Driving the net early.
Before the crowd even had a chance to sit down, Matthew Tkachuk gave them a reason to stand up.
Now a break here, and the first goal of the game will go to the Atlantic.
Good start, boys, good start.
A Florida Panther lighting up the crowd.
I like that sauce, Sasha.
Hey, that was a puck possession shift, fellas.
Despite the hot start for the locals, the Metro Division had plenty of firepower of its own.
Two quick goals by Gaudreau, 20 seconds apart.
That's a pretty good shift there, boys.
Led by Johnny Gaudreau.
Go for it, Johnny. Go for it, Johnny. There you go. There you go.
Fast, boys. Hey, that's right.
And two future Hall of Famers with perfect chemistry.
Ovechkin, Crosby, are you kidding?
The Metro appeared poised to pull away and spoil the party.
That's it, Ovi. That's it.
But Matthew Tkachuk was determined to tilt the ice back in favor of the Atlantic.
Let's go here, hey? Time to score.
Set the tone.
Set the tone.
Here we go. We need a goal, boys.
Pass deflected, and the rebound comes to Matthew Tkachuk, and he pots another.
That's it. We're back. We're so back.
Boys, I like the pace right now.
Oh, yeah, we're humming.
Led by the Tkachuk brothers, the Atlantic continued to push the pace and didn't let up.
Here's Matthew, Brady in front.
Oh! Check it. Last five, eh, hard, last five, hard. Get our chase game going.
He is in alone. Matthew Tkachuk scores. Atlantic's got the lead.
Hey, wait a minute, Shrugs. Wait a minute, buddy.
And it's by two now, as Matthew Tkachuk has his hat trick goal.
That's it, fella.
Four straight goals for the Atlantic. Under 3 minutes away from a trip to the championship game.
Empty net here for Dylan Larkin. Ovechkin trying to get back.
Yeah!
Larkin has the empty netter.
It's all habit.
Come on. What a defense!
Ah, boy.
Wow, what a comeback this has been.
There we go, boys.
Ted Assey.
It will be the Atlantic, led by the Tkachuks, to go on to play the Central in the final.
Great job,
boys. That's it. That's it. That's it. Yeah, hey.
We are going to have a first-time champion because neither the Central nor the Atlantic has ever won this in the first 6 years of the three-on-three tournament.
Hey, one step closer.
Nathan MacKinnon set the tone for the Central. They're into the final. You saw Matthew Tkachuk. He's a crowd favorite, the de facto home team here this weekend, the Atlantic Division. They're in the final. The stage is set. $1 million on the line.
Of course, money isn't the only thing on the line at this All-Star game. Yet to be decided, who will be the star of all the stars, the MVP?
Let's go.
Let's go, huh? Let's go.
Have a nice start.
There's an opportunity right off the faceoff, and it's shot wide by Mikko Rantanen. Out there with his AB teammates again, that was Cale Makar.
Picking up exactly where they left off in the first game, the brothers Tkachuk bring the hometown crowd to its feet.
Tkachuk, wraparound goal!
3 goals and 2 assists, and now he has his fourth.
This guy wants a Honda, boys. 19 wants a Honda bad.
They're starting to warm up the Honda Pilot Trail Sport for the MVP if Matthew Tkachuk can keep this going.
That's it, fellas, hey?
On fire. That's our start, boys.
So the Atlantic strikes first, and they go back to work here.
He's on fire. Big save. Big save.
But early on, defense and goaltending, usually a rarity in an All-Star game, somehow takes center stage.
Play a little man-on-man here. Gave the lizard tongue, hey? Save that one. Oh, yeah.
Come on, Pasta.
A chance for the Atlantic to go up by two, and Saros shuts the door.
Oh, big save.
All right, Jones.
Jones from the doorstep. Denied by Omar.
He got across, eh?
Oh, my God, hit his shoulder. I got to put it up more.
Seth Jones to the backhand, and a beautiful stop by Omar.
There's a bit of an edge here. The players are taking this seriously.
Here to win.
While there is an unexpected lack of offense, true to another All-Star tradition, there's no shortage of lighter moments.
Back the other way, Kirill Kaprizov handed it away. Breakaway Larkin, and he lost control of it.
Oh, my God. What happened?
Heads up, perfect pass, right on the tape. Oh, yeah, he plays for the other team. He ends up slapping it in the corner, which amuses Brady Tkachuk to no end.
That's hilarious.
That was weird, man.
Yeah.
Nearly 2 minutes gone by, 1-0 Atlantic.
Heads.
Long hit ahead. Here's MacKinnon. Nathan MacKinnon did not score.
Looked like it was in.
Oh, I thought that went in.
Yeah, I think a lot of folks in the crowd did too.
All right, we need to capitalize here, fellas.
Here comes the quick counter. Marner down low for the goal.
What a touch.
What a pass.
What a touch.
Nikita Kucherov, his second of the day.
You guys are buzzing.
These guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to start working.
Oh.
Nearly midway through the first half, 2-0, the Atlantic Division leads.
Yeah, we got to score another goal here.
Here comes another Larkin to the forehand, and he scores.
Humming, boys are humming.
And it's 3-0 Atlantic.
I needed that one.
And when the team switched sides after the first 10 minutes, Boston Bruins netminder Linus Ullmark has done something remarkable, stopped everything that came his way.
Hey, give it up for Linus, hey? Wow. Unreal.
Great save. Hey, good job in there, man. That's the first shutout I've seen in a period.
Who was in net the first half for them? Was it
Ullmark?
Huh? Ullmark? He's a big guy, too. I thought it was Vasilevsky. It looked like Vasilevsky.
In Peter DeBoer's defense, it's easy to get fooled when the players are this good. And with Ullmark through, it is Andre Vasilevsky's turn in the net, while Connor Hellebuck takes over for the Central.
You got time. A lot of time.
Here we go. Get one, get us going here. Let's get one.
Rantanen looks open, Makar, and McKinnon snapped that shot high.
The dog wants it.
Here's Kaprizov. Backhanded over the net.
Coach, they're coming.
You guys are coming here.
Boys are humming in white.
Despite the pressure from the Central, it's the Atlantic that adds to its lead.
Marner.
Oh my God.
And he scores. He sets up another goal by Dylan Larkin.
Yes. Love Larks. Love Larks.
Who says don't hand the keys to that Honda Pilot Trail Sport to Matthew Tkachuk just yet.
Can I really just stand up and give a yes?
Yeah, you did.
I really just do that?
You got leadership. You got leadership.
And as time winds down, the Tkachuk brothers' leadership on the bench is contagious.
We don't let off the gas here, hey, fellas?
Here's McKinnon nearly midway through the second half, and a goal for Mikko Rantanen.
The final few minutes brings a flurry of goals.
Robertson scores 5-2.
Including Dylan Larkin's third of the game.
He wants it, boys.
Another chance and another goal for Dylan Larkin. That's a hat trick tonight.
As the Atlantic Division holds on for the win.
And this one's going to end 7-5. And the Atlantic Division has won the 2023 All-Star Game.
Goalies win. Goalies win it for us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's go. Yeah. The old handshake, boys. Good job, boys. Good job.
Get the keys.
You're going to be MVP.
Okay. Larks, you deserve to get driven back, feet up in that car. Thank you.
Excited about getting that.
It's going to be awesome.
Matthew, what are you going to remember most about this weekend?
Having a lot of family and friends here and getting to celebrate with the great fans here in Florida. They've made it unbelievable. It's just been an honor to play in front of them this whole year, and it's great that the other players throughout the league can see what a great place this is to play.
It was a fun weekend, getting to know guys that I didn't know before.
Lots of good memories, lots of video.
I enjoy these things, and hopefully it's not my last.
We're here to put on a show, and I hope we did that. I hope fans enjoyed it. They put on a great event here, so it was fun to be part of.
When all was said and done, the stars had aligned in South Florida for a perfect hockey weekend.
Sparky, come right next to me.
What was it like playing with the two Tkachuks?
I mean, it was actually fun. I wasn't expecting that.
For him to be able to deal with Brady and I, he should have won MVP for just dealing with us.
Without everybody saying it, it kind of, revolves around us a little bit with, having the home crowd on our side and, doing the big skills. Starting the game, having the fans basically just cheer for us. It's a big deal.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
We definitely felt that we had to do our part throughout the weekend to show what a great place and what great fans we have. And I know we both enjoyed everything that we did, and it was just an awesome weekend, all around.